During the handover ceremony of startup kits to 104 project-affected persons by Tilenga Oilfield in Bulisa District, leaders and residents in Bulisa have asked the oil company to support the management of Kirama Vocational Training Institute that has been abandoned for the past 7 years.
We need to make sure that the interventions we make are consistent with the needs of the community. And the backbone of what we are celebrating today is an element customized to the needs of the graduates.
The support rendered through the startup kits follows the completion of various vocational skills training programs by PAPS after a needs assessment was conducted from the 4 RAP 1 villages of Chisomere, Kirama, Kasenyi, and Kilima in Bulisa.
These startup kits were carefully selected. We actually got the input from the vocational training institutions on what are the key tools required by PAPS to enter into a business.
During the function held at Chisomere Primary School in Gwendu Sub County in Bulisa District, Mariam Nampera Mboa, the Deputy General Manager at Total Energies Uganda, has noted that the startup kits were identified and procured for the 104 PAPS and the different categories of vocational programs. 12 tailors, 5 hairdressers, 70 mechanics, 5 plumbers, 6 caterers, and 6 welders.
That what we have delivered is commensurate to the needs of the project affected persons.
According to Lukumo, the beneficiaries of these startup kits went through training centers, which include Bohimba Technical Institute, St. Simon Vocational Training College, Millennium Business School, Prestige Driving School, and Christian Driving School, which are all kilometers far from Bulisa District.
That Total joins the hand with Bulisa District establishment to make sure that facility is operationalized. These are not enough. We need more training of more people, not only for getting employment, but for even becoming employers.
The Vocational Institute situated in Kirama Village in Kugwera Sub-County is currently lying idle and surrounded by bushes. It was constructed 10 years back by the community with support from the Uganda Wildlife Authority under the revenue sharing scheme.
And why is this? Just because locally here, Bulisa District doesn't have a single vocational training school. The local community conceived an idea of establishing a vocational training center.
Nora Bijira, the Bulisa Woman Member of Parliament, who has been the chief guest, has noted that many youths from the district would want to get vocational skills and work in the crucial oil and gas sector. But due to the non-operational vocational training institutes, the youth have missed out on several opportunities.
Especially when it comes to different levels of employment, starting from the casual workers, we also want inclusiveness when it comes to middle managers.
Stephen Biaruhanga, the Bulisa Resident District Commissioner, has tasked Total Energies to investigate and terminate contracts of service providers who are not providing services yet they are being paid.
Because those companies are eating a lot of money on behalf of our people here. We would have got so many trainings. We would have got so many skills if some of them were not quank companies.
The 104 beneficiaries underwent a 3-month vocational training that started in November 2021 and lasted until March this year. Report by Ambrose Nwagabakatoto for the news.